Welcome to Longhorn Gymnasium and the University of New Hampshire. In the event of an emergency or fire alarm activation, exit doors are located at either end of the gymnasium. Out the west end of the building, please move across the concourse and down the staircase or down the stadium stairs. Once outside, please move safely away from the building. Thank you.
Thank you. Somersworth High School and Career Technical Center's 2017 graduation ceremony. It's my distinct pleasure to introduce to you the graduating class of 2017. I would now ask senior members of the choirs to come forward carefully. Senior members of the chorus. I would ask that everyone please stand for the national anthem, and we do ask you to remove your hats. Good evening, 2017 graduates, Mayor Hillier, Superintendent Jenny Mosca, Somersworth School Board Chair Don Austin, Rollinsford School Board Vice Chair Tom Kunz, members of the Somersworth and Rollinsford School Boards, members of the Somersworth City Council, members of the Rollinsford Board of Selectmen, parents, family members, colleagues, students, and friends. Whew. Thank you for joining the administration and staff of Somersworth High School and Career and Technical Center in this special ceremony celebrating the achievement of earning a high school diploma. These graduates have completely fulfilled their graduation requirements for the state of New Hampshire. Many students have faced challenges in order to march today, and all have truly earned the honor of being part of today's graduation procession and ceremony. I am proud to be your principal, and again, I think I forgot to introduce myself. My name is Vic Sokol. It's now my pleasure to introduce our first speaker, the Honorable Dana Hillier, Mayor of the City of Somersworth.
Good Good evening. Regardless of the languages we speak, the customs we practice, or the flag we pledge to, all of us are linked together by the same universal strands. To be respected, live life free from violence and oppression, and to seek and find love. Over 2,017 years ago, a young carpenter in his famous Sermon on the Mount would lead followers with a new commandment of love thy neighbor and do unto others. Other major religions throughout the world guide us with similar advice, that of respecting one another and every living thing before us. We are born pure and unspoiled by the tainted influences of the sometimes misplaced values of humanity and society, still growing towards achieving the enlightenment of understanding of our fragile existence, of our understanding of our interconnection of every living thing, of our interconnection to each other. Your journey over the last 12 years has been to develop the foundation and understanding of how critical being safe, respectful, responsible, and cooperative will play throughout your life, how critical honoring and celebrating each other is, and how recognizing and accepting the vast diversity throughout our city, state, nation, and world, how critical it will be to stand up for those who would steal your dignity, mistreat you, or violate your guaranteed rights in the Declaration of Independence and United States Constitution. These are the important things which guide all of us. These are the important things which continue to connect each and every one of us. These are the important things and value life lessons. One does not need to search the tack of ancient wisdom or self-validation as to why each and every one of us is to be honored, respected, and celebrated. One does not need to know or search words in the Bible, Tao or Quran, to seek strength, courage, or serenity, or to understand that each person's life and existence in this moment is so special. For sometimes the lyrics of a simple song summarize your personal life and journey, and that of all of those around you. Class of 2017, on behalf of the city of Somersworth, I share with you some departing advice from Lady Gaga. It doesn't matter if you love him or capital H-I-M. Graduates, just put your paws up, because you were born this way, baby. My mama told me when I was young that we were all born superstars. She rolled my hair and put my lipstick on in the glass of her boudoir. There's nothing wrong with loving who you are, she said, because you were made perfect, babe. So hold your head up, girl, and you'll go far. Listen to me when I say, I'm beautiful in my way because God makes no mistakes. I'm on the right track, baby. I was born this way. Don't hide yourself in regret. Just love yourself and your set. I'm on the right track, baby. I was born this way. Ooh, there ain't no other way. Baby, I was born this way. Baby, I was born this way. Ooh, there ain't no other way. Baby, I was born this way. Right track, baby. I was born this way. Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Don't be a drag, just be a queen. Give yourself friends and love your friends so we can all rejoice your truth. In the religion of insecure, I must admit by myself and respect my youth. A different lover is not a sin, believe, capital H-I-M, hey, hey, hey. I love my life, I love this record, may amore, may for, yay. I'm beautiful in my way, cause God makes no mistakes, I'm on the right track, baby, I was born this way. Don't hide yourself in regret, love yourself and your set, I'm on the right track, baby, I was born this way. Ooh, there ain't no other way, baby, I was born this way, baby. I was born this way. Ooh, there ain't no other way. Baby, I was born this way. Right track, baby. You were born this way. Whether you're broke or evergreen, your black, white, beige, chocolate descent, your Lebanese, your Orient, whether life's disabilities left you outcast, bullied, or teased, rejoice and love yourself today. Because, baby, you were born this way. No matter gay, straight, or bi, lesbian, transgender life, I'm on the right track. Baby, I was born to survive. No matter black, white, or beige, chocolate, or Orient, baby, I'm on the right track. I was born to be brave. I'm beautiful in my way, because God makes no mistakes. I'm on the right track. Baby, I was born this way. Don't hide yourself in regret. Just love yourself in your set. I'm on the right track. Baby, I was born this way. I was born this way, hey. I was born this way, hey. I'm on the right track. Baby, I was born this way, hey. Congratulations on your accomplishments. Best wishes as you continue to work towards your goals, dreams, and aspirations. Know that Somersworth will always be your home. And may your blood forever run Hilltopper blue. Thank you. For the last 7 years, Superintendent Mosca has guided our school district. Not only is it your graduation this evening, but in some ways, hers, as she begins her journey into enjoying retirement. We are forever grateful for her leadership and her guidance and continuing to build upon the dreams of each and every youth within our SAU 56 school district. On behalf of the city of Somersworth, I'd like to present her with a proclamation this evening. Whereas Jenny Mosca served as superintendent of schools from 2010 and 2011, and whereas Jenny Mosca served as Jenny Mosca served as superintendent of schools from 2011 to 2017, and whereas under her leadership, schools within the SAU 56 have gained national attention for lowering the achievement gap, positive behavioral intervention models, response to intervention models, and district-wide imperatives. And whereas with her vision and compassion, the unified basketball team was created at Somersworth High School. And whereas she hates paperclips, will not use a pencil that is dull, and knows everything that has been moved on her desk. Now therefore, I, Dana S. Hilliard, Mayor of the City of Somersworth, New Hampshire, on behalf of the Somersworth City Council, do proclaim Thursday, June 8, 2017, as Jenny Mosca Day in the City of Somersworth. And by the power vested in me through the office of mayor, further proclaim Jenny Mosca as an honorary Hilltopper for life. Thank you for your attention.
I go back to the root of how our past started and will close with the following words of wisdom. Share everything. Play nice. Pick up your things where you found them. Clean up your own mess. Say sorry when you hurt someone's feelings. Flush. Live a balanced life. Learn lots, think lots. Take a nap every afternoon. Watch for traffic. Hold hands and stick together as there is strength in numbers. Reflect and tell someone daily that you love them. Own your mistakes. Don't judge. Be open to all that comes your way. Parents, family members here tonight, you have witnessed a transformation from the first day your son or daughter tore away from you to get on a bus, to go to kindergarten with their Spider-Man and Barbie lunchboxes. You watch them develop over the years, have successes and disappointments. You supported their after-school activities, fundraisers, parent-teacher conferences, calls from school that were good, and those that were not quite so pleasant. You brought things to school when they left them behind, even though your child is now a senior. Graduating class, I wish you the best as you embark upon the next phase of your life, and remember all of those you have helped along the way. Thank you.
Thank you, Jane. How many of the members of the graduating class are going to go in the United States military? Stand up. It's my pleasure right now to introduce the Somersworth High School and Career and Technical Center Senior Chorus, who will sing Seasons of Love, written by Jonathan Larson, under the direction of Julie McTague. Thank you. I now have the honor to introduce the 2017 valedictorian, Hunter Gosling.
Outside the safety of the halls of SHS, I'm not smart enough or tough enough
to do what it takes to live my life as I dreamed it will be. Will I let my parents go? Will I miss out on something? What if I don't fit in? What if I end up alone? What if I settle? As much as that scares me, I take comfort from you. I take comfort in knowing that as I blaze my path into the future, you are there with me, beside me. Each of us on our path, but plowing forward to make our future a promising landscape of prosperity and pride. What I have learned from the protection of the halls of SHS is we can do anything if we're willing to work for it. I mean, I am up here talking to you right now, and I think only my parents are more shocked than I am. I'm here because I put my nose to the books and worked my butt off.
Say butt, right?
That's what it's going to take from all of us to have those lives we dream of and squeeze all we can out of every opportunity. I am ready, but we have to do it together because we are going to need each other out there. No topper left behind. Me, I take in the words of a wise and thoughtful soul, Dwight Schrute, when I say I am ready to face any challenges that might be foolish enough to face me. Are you with me? Congratulations, my friends. May the odds be ever in your favor.
Our next speaker is my honor to introduce the class salutatorian and class president, Mason Cashman.
This evening is an occasion of momentous importance. As we students are aware, and everyone here has probably heard countless times, graduation marks a change in our lives. We will soon no longer be students, but graduates of Somersworth High School. Our responsibilities will increase in number and certainly in intensity. Our graduation, though, is about more than just these changes happening in the near future. We are also here to look back at the changes that we have encountered on our journeys to where we are now. We have all changed so much over these past 13 years in school, and undoubtedly, we will change more. Why change? Well, change is what keeps us progressing. Change is what allows us to move forward, in life and in work. Change is what ultimately allows us to become better people. And so, as we know we have all changed and will continue to do so, I ask you, my classmates, the Somersworth High School class of 2017, who are you now? Think of all that you've done, all that you've accomplished to make it this far. Think of what you have overcome to find yourself in the position you are in today. Sitting here at the end of your high school years, moments from receiving your diploma, and being a graduate of Somersworth High School. Consider your friends, old and new, gained and lost. Consider your family. Consider yourself. I know almost all of us have something in our minds that we believe nobody else could come close to having experienced or come close to understanding. And with that, you may very well be right. But you would be wrong to think that nobody would care. Care about you, what you've experienced, or simply who you are. I know that we have all faced our hardships through our years in high school and earlier. Many of us are not alone in what we face. I know that through my personal struggles with anxiety, depression, and coming to accept my sexuality, I was not the only person facing these difficulties. And even in those times, I did feel I was alone. I knew I always had and still have the people who support and care about me. We all, in our own ways, learned that we are a class of empathy. We are a class of sympathy. We are a class of trust, a class of care, a class of understanding, a class of hope, a class of joy, a class of pride, a class of dedication, a class of love, a class of love, a class of, yes, I am using that term, a class of love, of love, of love. We work together. We support each other because we know that if someone is left behind, we we are no longer whole. A person that I admire for their strength, their dedication, and their care is the designer Jeremy Scott, someone I identify with greatly and find as a huge inspiration in my life and my work. Throughout his life, Jeremy Scott has faced and overcome what is to me an unfathomable amount of hurdles and roadblocks in his career and personal life. Growing up in a small town in Missouri, Scott was incredibly self-conscious about his outward image. In his late teens, he developed depression and anxiety, which he notes is due in part to hiding his sexual orientation for so many years. When he realized, though, that all the people who mattered in his life were still there, supporting and carrying him through everything, Scott was able to work towards the dreams and goals that he had set for himself. You may now recognize Jeremy Scott from his self-titled fashion label, he has worked with Adidas, or the fashion label Moschino, of which he has been creative director since 2013. He designs personally for artists including Katy Perry, Lady Gaga, and Beyonce, and has hosted fashion shows across the globe. In the documentary of his life and work, Jeremy Scott, the People's Designer, he closes with a remark that will always stay with me. I want to leave a legacy of a smile. He prompts us to remember that people will not forget how you made them feel, to remember that people will never forget how you treated them. I believe that all of us here today should do just as Jeremy Scott invites. Fellow graduates, I invite all of us to take this support, this care, this dedication, this commitment, and all else that we have learned and received and experienced, and bring that support with us into the rest of our journeys. When someone needs help, consider lending a hand. Give words of encouragement. Hold doors for others. Laugh with your friends. Appreciate the time you spend with those that matter to you. Go pet some dogs. I hope that all of us can take what we have learned from each other and bring it wherever we go. In doing this, we can all leave a legacy of a smile. Thank you.
My pleasure to introduce the Somersworth High School and Career and Technical Center Concert Band, who will perform Earth Dance by Michael Sweeney under the direction of band director and Somersworth Teacher of the Year, Mr. Matthew Lagarde. honored guest speaker tonight. On behalf of the class of 2017, I'm pleased to introduce a faculty member who has been chosen by the graduating class to be their main speaker tonight. This gentleman is a third grade teacher at Maplewood Elementary School. He has, at times, been referred to as Mr. Somersworth. He's been selected as a Chamber of Commerce Teacher of the Year. He gives back to the community in many ways. He does announcing at SHS sporting events, and he takes all new teachers on a bus tour of the city during the first teacher workshop days at the beginning of each year. He has a wealth of knowledge about Somersworth and an outstanding classroom teacher. Please help me welcome Eric Momsen.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, thank you. To the Somersworth High School senior class of 2017, you guys are absolutely wonderful, each and every one of you. It is an honor and a pleasure to stand before you this evening here at the 156th graduation ceremony of our great high school. Seems like only yesterday that I sat out there where you sit today, dressed in my top of blue cap and gown, waiting for my name to be called. In reality, though, 34 years have come and gone since that June day back in the spring of 83. And so I stand before you today, a little older, a little grayer, with a little more life experience, but yet in so many ways, still very, very much like each and every one of you. Imagine for a moment, imagine 10,354 people. No, don't worry, I'm not talking about the crowd size here tonight. No, you see in the proud and storied history of this great city of ours, 10,354 people have walked across this stage ahead of you. Proud alumni of Somersworth High School, generations of hardworking, caring, and talented young men and women just like you and I. They are the proud past of our great school and city. You are the bright future. You see, back in 1849, the New Hampshire State Legislature enacted what was called the Somersworth Act. The Somersworth Act, allowing the cities and towns of New Hampshire for the first time to develop school districts, create systems of graded schools, and purchase lots and build public schoolhouses. Later that year, land was purchased atop Prospect Hill in Somersworth, and Great Falls High School was built. Opened in 1850, it was the first public high school in the state of New Hampshire. And the wonderful young people who walked through the doors of that historic building high upon the hill became forever known as Hilltoppers. Tonight, my friends, as you write another chapter in the great story of Somersworth High School, understand that when you walk across this stage and receive your diploma, you do not walk alone. Rather, 10,354 of us walk with you, wanting only the very best for each one of you in the years ahead, wherever the roads of life may take you. Ever so proud of each and every one of you as you join our great race tonight. For in a moment, you'll move that blue and white tassel from one side of your cap to the other, and you will suddenly become alumni. And then 10,354 will become 10,468. Somersworth High School will become your alma mater, the school where you used to go. Next time you walk down those hallowed halls of Somersworth High School, it will be different. Something called nostalgia will set in. You see, nostalgia is when you look back and see things through a different set of eyes. Everywhere you look, you will see the reminders of great times that you had inside those walls. And we'll remember the wonderful, wonderful people who helped you create those great memories. The very best of friends that a person could ever ask for. Friends whom you have talked, laughed, and cried with a thousand times through the years. And as you reminisce back, you will realize something about your wonderful teachers as well. For you see, the Latin phrase alma mater, dating back to the 1600s, translates into something or someone who has provided nourishment. Yes, our hardworking, dedicated, and caring teachers and staff members of Somersworth High School and of all of the other buildings which you have passed through over the last 13 years were never your enemies. Rather, we've been on your side all along, trying our very best to provide you with nourishment, nourishment of mind and soul, to help you build a solid foundation for a successful life. Appreciate them always. Somersworth, New Hampshire is a great community, one that often doesn't get the credit that it truly deserves. As a child growing up in a military family, I followed my father around wherever he was stationed. From the deserts of California, where I was born back in 65, to the shores of Rota, Spain, all across this country and around the world. Then one day in the summer of 79, my father retired, and we ended up here in the Hilltop City, just days before my freshman year of high school. After graduation off to college in Springfield, Massachusetts, Plymouth, New Hampshire, and then here at the University of New Hampshire in Durham. Then I look back on all the places that I'd ever lived and ever been, deciding where I wanted to settle down and spend the rest of my life. I am forever proud to call Somersworth, New Hampshire, my home. Understand, though, that as you travel through life, you will always meet other people, people from warmer places, people from bigger cities, people from wealthier communities. Nice people, but they will always try to convince you that the grass is always greener somewhere else. That's okay, though. Let them believe that if they wish. They wouldn't understand anyways. You see, they are not Somersworth Hilltoppers. They do not have topper pride. For some reason, they were not the chosen ones. You and I, however, we know the truth. For you, we can see beyond the little imperfections of our community and can open our eyes to the wonderful aspects of our childhood that have been forever woven into the very tapestry of who we are today and always will be. Decades from now, you will reminisce back upon the simplest of Somersworth things. Simple things like walking up those legendary stairs to Noble Pines 100 times or more. You will count those old wooden steps in your dreams forevermore. Simple things like walking down Memorial Drive to Cumbie's to buy a tub of blue slush, and then sitting out on that famous old concrete wall outside the store and talking and laughing and joking with your friends. Yes, we are toppers. Our hearts forever bleed topper blue. And that means something. appreciate these great communities of Somersworth and Rollinsford, New Hampshire. Always be proud of where you are from. Our communities are not perfect, no city or town is, but we have some of the finest people in the world living here. And at the end of the day, that's what really matters. Wherever the roads of life may take you in the years and decades that lie ahead, whether you stay here in the greatest state or travel off to distant lands, always be proud of your home. You and I, my friends, are forever Hilltoppers. Every year I love going to watch the Somersworth High School play. Our drama club always does an absolutely amazing job. Incredible talent out there. A few months ago in the CTC's amazing new black box theater, Pippin came to life. In case you didn't catch it, there was a simple lesson to that story of Pippin that so many people often overlook in life. You see, Pippin, young Pippin, a prince, the heir to the throne, sets off to follow his grand dreams, looking for three things: profound meaning, complete ultimate fulfillment, and perfection. Singing, "I'm extraordinary, I've got to do extraordinary things." Sound familiar? Familiar perhaps because I'm describing so many of you as you set off upon your journeys in life. Pippin tries his hand at being a mighty soldier and a great ruler, but it doesn't make him happy. He sings, "I wanted magic shows and miracles, mirages to touch. I wanted so much. Crimson, gold, and lavender, a shining parade." But at the end of the day, even though he had everything he wanted, he didn't want what he had. Yes, he had wealth and fame and name and all of that noise, but in his own words, he didn't have any of those simple joys. No, none of those simple joys. In the end, Pippin finds true happiness as he returns to a meaningful life on a simple rural farm, back to the wonderful woman who loves him and the young stepson who admires him dearly, and the loving family pet, an adorable duck who follows the little boy around everywhere he goes. Oh, and spoiler alert for those of you who have never seen Pippin. Technically, the little dog doesn't get to live happily ever after. It kind of keels over halfway through the play. But that's a life lesson for another day. Now, where was it? Seriously, though, maybe some of the best advice we need to know about our life's journey, maybe we can learn from Pippin. My friends, as you set off to conquer the world, always remember that it's okay to return home and come to the genuine realization that it is the simple joys of life and the wonderful people around you that really matter. Over 700 students have walked through my classroom door through the years. None of them have ever grown up to become president, play in the NFL, or walk upon the moon. But they are very successful and very happy. I can see the happiness as I read their Facebook posts, celebrating the simple joys of their lives, a wedding, landing their first job, sitting around a campfire in the backyard, saving up enough money for a down payment on their first home, their son's kindergarten graduation, those Valentine's Day daddy-daughter dances with their little girl. Yes, the simple joys of life are the real treasures, my friend, not the power, wealth, or fame. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. When I sat down to think about whatever advice I would give to graduating seniors, I came to the realization that it really isn't that much different than the simple things that I say to my third grade students each and every day. Believe in yourself. Believe in yourselves as much as I believe in you. You'll do fine in life. Be kind to one another. Be kind to everyone you meet. There is not enough kindness in this world today. Be the ones who change that. Be there for one another. Help each other out in times of need. Forgive one another. Yes, care about other people as much as you care about yourselves. Oh, that tomorrow morning I would wake up and the newspaper editors who have to summarize my speech into 3 or 4 words would have written the simple headline, "Be kind and caring." Take the time to truly appreciate those around you. Appreciate your friends. Appreciate your loving parents. Appreciate your teachers and coaches. And yes, even appreciate your siblings. Press the pause button on your busy lives from time to time. Remember to look up from your cell phones once in a while. Take the time to stop and look people in the eye and thank them for all the wonderful things that they've done for you through the years. Tell them that you love them. As we all know, there is never any guarantee that tomorrow will ever come. Enjoy and truly appreciate the wonderful people in your lives today and every day. As you go off to project graduation tonight, enjoy the time that you still have together. As the Somersworth High School class of 2017, these really are the best years of your life. You will spend the next 70 years trying to figure out how to build a time machine to take you back to the good old days of Somersworth High. Yes, in the blink of an eye, you'll be getting a letter in the mail inviting you to your 10th year high school class reunion. You'll be saying, "But it feels like I just graduated yesterday." Life has a way of flying by. Be sure to slow down and truly enjoy it. Because before you know it, the letters you receive in the mail each day will be about joining the AARP and getting life alert bracelets and understanding reverse mortgages. Your parents are laughing. My friends, most importantly of all, be safe in all you do. Make good choices each and every day. Stay out of trouble, please. I still worry about you, and I always will. We worry about you. We really do. You're absolutely wonderful, each and every one of you. Love you lots. This city loves you lots. Always remember that. In closing, I say to you those simple words that I so often say. Go Toppers. You're the best.
Thank you. section in this piece, we have Matt Tom Lang on the drums, Dylan Zinkovich on the bass, and Kathy Fink on the keyboards. There'll be a point in this song where you all can join in if you like, and I'll make it really clear when that is. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
It's now my pleasure to introduce our Dean of School Operations and Career and Technical Center, Director Mrs. Caitlin Carrington, and our Dean of Students, Mrs. Christina Smith, as they present this year's awards and scholarships.
Announced, the graduate will rise. We'll ask the audience to clap once for each name and the graduate to remain standing until the conclusion of the presentation of all scholarships and awards. Once all recipients have been recognized, please congratulate them collectively with a loud applause. Mariah Wachowski, Roger Dean Morales Memorial Scholarship 3000, Somersworth High School National Honor Society 500, Alexis Beauvais, Bart N. DeLarma Memorial Scholarship 3000, Joan Rhodes Memorial Scholarship 500, Somersworth Association of Educators 650, Mason Cashman, UT Youth Scholarship 75, Harry Stein Memorial Scholarship 1000, Randy Cummins Memorial Scholarship 1000, Somersworth High School Run by 1000, Somersworth High School Student Council Scholarship 500, Somersworth American Legion Post 69 Scholarship 2000, Women's Club of Somersworth 1000. Taryn Connolly, Bill Canteen Memorial Scholarship 100, New Hampshire Charitable Foundation Somersworth Success Fund 2500, Bellamy Fields Assisted Living Scholarship 500, Jaden Croto, Dennis Flanagan Memorial Scholarship 750, Mary Riley Memorial Scholarship 250, Norman Valley Memorial Scholarship 300, Randy Cummins Memorial Scholarship 1000, Somersworth Athletic Association Scholarship 500, Jeffrey Frank Burr Senior Memorial Scholarship 500. Alicia Fossey, Richard and Estelle Memorial Scholarship 500, Joseph Berline, Dennis Flanagan Memorial Scholarship 500, Tanya Portier, Juan's Club of Dover Scholarship 500, Somersworth American Legion Post 69 Scholarship 2000, Somersworth Sons of the American Legion 500, New Hampshire Charitable Foundation Somersworth Success Fund 2500. Hunter Gosselin, Richard Royal Eastman Memorial Scholarship 100, New Hampshire Red Sox Scholarship 1000. Sylvia Helmonton, Northeast Credit Union 1000, Bryant Mosberg Trust Scholarship 500, Jeffrey Franker Senior Memorial Scholarship 500. Kaylee Kinsey, the Ryan Hosley Senior Memorial Scholarship 750. Avery Coachmeyer, Donald Pulowski Memorial Scholarship 400, Jeffrey Franker Senior Memorial Scholarship 500. JT Lorien, Somersworth Athletic Association Scholarship 500.
Caitlin Lavoie, the Dennis Flanagan Memorial Scholarship, $500, the Timothy Tapscott Memorial Scholarship, $500, the Bryant Mosberg Trust Scholarship, $500, the Rollinsford Selkirk Lions Club, $300. Jeanette Morassi, the Somersworth High School National Honor Society, $500. Callie McGuire, Federal Savings Bank, $1,000, the Educational Talent Search Scholarship, $1,000. Holly Morse, Greater Somersworth Chamber of Commerce, $500, Wentworth Douglas Hospital Auxiliary Millennium Scholarship, $1,000, the American Legion Post 47 Memorial Scholarship, $1,000, and the Somersworth High School National Honor Society Scholarship, $250. Mackenzie Patton, the Casey Walters Memorial Scholarship, $2,000. Casey Fritto, Somersworth American Legion Post 69 Scholarship, $2,000. Lindsay Provincia, the George Nato Memorial Scholarship, $3,000. Andrew Sewell, the Ryan Osberg Hockey Scholarship, $500. Annalise Spinney, Youth to Youth Scholarship, $75. Ariana Sullivan, the Honore D. Roulette Scholarship, $1,000, and the Somersworth Selkirk Lions Club, $300. Camden Tillencast, the Frisbee Memorial Scholarship, $1,000, the Frisbee Art Scholarship, $500, the Women's Club of Somersworth, $1,000, the Somersworth High School National Honor Society Scholarship, $500, and the Greater Somersworth Chamber of Commerce, $500. Big round of applause for all of them. Recipients to come up to the stage. The Jack E. Furlan Memorial Award. This award is given in memory of Mrs. Furlan, a Latin teacher at Somersworth High School. This is awarded to a senior who most exemplifies the qualities of warmth, sincerity, sense of humor, enthusiasm, positive attitude, school spirit, and genuine interest in others. This award is presented to Hunter Gosling. This year, the award is presented to Ryan Lewis.
Thank you, Peter and Christina. At this point in time, we will proceed with the presentation of diplomas by Somersworth School Board Chairperson Don Austin and Rollinsburg School Board Vice Chairman Tom Collins. This is how we're going to do it. Class President Mason Cashman will receive the first diploma. He will remain on stage and announce his class officers. After they receive their diplomas, Mason and Mariah will announce their classmates in alphabetical order, row by row. As has been the tradition, once the recipient's name has been read, the graduating class will acknowledge that person by a unified clap. We encourage members of the audience to join the senior class for that clap. Mr. Austin and Mr. Coons, are you guys ready? Mrs. Sloan and Mr. Pelletier, are you ready? Class marshals, are you ready? Prepare the first row. Receiving the first diploma for the graduating class of 2017 is Class President Mason Matthew Cashman.
Joy Amaro. Nicholas Michael Anderson. Austin Lee Perchelski. Evan Joseph Perchelski. Olivia Murray Bissett. Thomas Bonifon III. TJ Bono. Todd Joseph Belanger. Patrick Brady. Sadie Rose Burgess. Haley Marie Camp. Brent Reginald Carter. Haley Jean Champagne. Zachary Club. Taryn Connolly. Ian Conroy. Sophie Cody. Tayden Tyler Coyne. Megan Diana Curran. Cody John Currier. Emma Marie Davis. Faith Dean. Alexander Nicholas DeJesus. Yeah.
Alicia Foster.
Maria.
Mark Marquis. Summer Soledad Martinez. Logan John May. Kaliana McGuire. Thomas McNeil. Cameron Michael Mick. Rafael Alfonso Miranda. Joshua Modestman.
Thank you.
Nicolo Susi.
Please drive safely as you leave and travel through home.